गुं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमम् ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पत आनः शृण्वन्नोतिभिः सेदसाधनम् प्रणो देवी सरस्वती वाजेभिर्वाजिनीवती धीनामवित्रयवतो गणेशाय नमः सरस्वत्यै नमः श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ॐ ॐ नमो भगवते रुद्राय ॐ नमस्ते रुद्रमन्यव उतोत इषवे नमः नमस्ते अस्तु धन्वने बाहुभ्यामुतते नमः यात इषु शिवतमा शिवं बभूवते धनुः शिवा शरव्यायातवतया नो रुद्रमृडया याते रुद्रशिवा तनोरघोरा पापकाशिनी तया नस्तनुवाशन्तमया गिरिशन्ताभि चाकषीः यामि शृङ्गिरिशन्तहस्ते बिभर्ष्यस्तवे शिवाङ्गिरित्रतां कुरु माहि गुंसि पुरुषं जगत् शिवेन वचसा त्वा गिरिशाच्चावदामसि यथा नः सर्वमिज्जगद यक्ष्मगुं सुमना असत् अध्यवोच दधि वक्ता प्रथमो दैव्योऽभिषक् अहीगश्च सर्वाञ्जम्भयन् सर्वाश्च यातु धान्यः असौ यस्ताम्रो अरुण उत बभ्रः सुमङ्गलः ये चेमागुं रुद्रा अभितो दिक्षश्रुता सहस्रशो वैशागुं हेड ईमहे असौ यो वसर्पति नीलग्रीवो विलोहितः उतैनं गोपा अदृशन्नदृशन्नुदहार्यः उतैनं विश्वा भूतानि स दृष्टो मृडयातिनः नमो अस्तु नीलग्रीवाय सहस्राक्षाय मीढुषे
अथो ये
अस्य सत्त्वानो हन्तेभ्यो करन् नमः प्रमुञ्च धन्वनस्त्वमुभयोरार्त्नियोर्ज्या याश्च ते हस्त इषवः पराता भगवो वपा अवतत्य धनुस्त्वगुं सहस्राक्षशते शुधे निशीर्य शल्यानामुखा शिवो नः सुमना भव विज्यं धनुः कपर्दिनो विशल्यो बाणवागुम् उत अनेशन्नस्येष व आभुरस्य निषङ्गतिः याते हेतिर्मीडुष्ठमहस्ते बभूवते धनुः तयास्मान् विश्वतस्त्वमयक्ष्मया परिभुजा नमस्ते अस्त्वायुधाय नातताय धृष्णवे उभाभ्यामुतते नमो बाहुभ्यान्तव धन्वने परिते धन्वनो हेतिरस्मान् पृणक्तु विश्वतः अथो य इषुधिस्तवारे अस्मन्निदेहितम् नमस्ते अस्तु भगवन् विश्वेश्वराय महादेवाय त्रयम्बकाय त्रिपुरांतकाय त्रिकाग्निकालाय कालाग्निरुद्राय नीलकंठाय मृत्युंजयाय सर्वेश्वराय सदाशिवाय श्रीमन्महादेवाय नमः। नमो हिरण्यबाहवे सेनान्ये दिशाञ्च पतये, नमो नमो वृक्षेभ्यो हरिकेशेभ्यः पशूनां पतये, नमो नमः सस्पिञ्जराय त्विषीमते पथीनां पतये, नमो नमो बभ्लुषाय विव्याधिनेन्नानां पतये, नमो नमो हरिकेशायोपवीतिने पुष्टानां पतये, नमो नमो भवस्य हेत्यै जगतां पतये, नमो नमो रुद्राय ततारिणेक्षे क्षेत्राणां पतये, नमो नमः सूताय हन्त्याय वनानां पतये, नमो नमो रोहिताय स्थपतये वृक्षाणां पतये, नमो नमो मन्त्रिणे वाणिजाय कक्षाणां पतये, नमो नमो भुवन्तये वारिवस्कृतायौषधीनां पतये, नमो नम उच्चैर्घोषाय क्रन्दयते पत्येनां पतये, नमो नमः कृष्णवीताय धावते सत्वनां पतये नमः। नमः सहमानाय निव्याधिन आव्याधिनीनां पतये, नमो नमः ककुभाय निषङ्गिणे स्तेनानां पतये, नमो नमो निषङ्गिण इषु धिमते तस्कराणां पतये, नमो नमो वञ्चते परिवञ्चते स्कायूनां पतये, नमो नमो निचेरवे परिचरायारण्यानां पतये, नमो नमस्रिकाविभ्यो जिगागुं सद्भ्यो मुष्णतां पतये, नमो नमो सिमद्भ्यो नक्तं चरद्भ्यः प्रकृन्तानां पतये, नमो नम उष्णीषिणे गिरिचराय कुलुञ्चानां पतये, नमो नम इषुमद्भ्यो धन्वाविभ्यश्च वो नमो नम आतन्वानेभ्यः प्रतिदधानेभ्यश्च वो नमो नम आयच्छद्भ्यो विसृजद्भ्यश्च वो नमो नमोऽस्यद्भ्यो विद्यद्भ्यश्च वो नमो नम आसीनेभ्यश्च यानेभ्यश्च वो नमो नम स्वपद्भ्यो जाग्रद्भ्यश्च वो नमो नमस्तिष्ठद्भ्यो धावद्भ्यश्च वो नमो नमः सभाभ्यः सभापतिभ्यश्च वो नमो नमो अश्वेभ्यो अश्वपतिभ्यश्च वो नमः। नम आव्याधिनीभ्यो विविध्यन्तेभ्यश्च वो नमो नम उगणाभ्यस्त्रिगुंहतेभ्यश्च वो नमो नमो गृत्सेभ्यो गृत्सपतिभ्यश्च वो नमो नमो व्रातेभ्यो व्रातपतिभ्यश्च वो नमो नमो गणेभ्यो गणपतिभ्यश्च वो नमो नमो विरूपेभ्यो विश्वरूपेभ्यश्च वो नमो नमो महद्भ्यः क्षुल्लकेभ्यश्च वो नमो नमो रथिभ्यो रथेभ्यश्च वो नमो नमो रथेभ्यो रथपतिभ्यश्च वो नमो नमः सेनाभ्यः सेनानिभ्यश्च वो नमो नमः Kshatrubhyas Sangrahitrubhyascha Vo Namo Namah Stakshabhyo Rathakarebhyascha Vo Namo Namah Kulalebhya Karmarebhyascha Vo Namo Namah Punjishtebhyo Nisharebhyascha Vo Namo Namah Ishukridbhyo Dhanvakridbhyascha Vo Namo Namah Mrugayubhyashvanibhyascha Vo Namo Namah Shvabhyashvapatibhyascha Vo Namah Namo Bhavaya Cha Rudraya Cha Namah Sharvaya Cha Pashupataye Cha Namo Neelagrivaya Cha Shitikanthaya Cha Namah Kapardine Cha Vyuktakeshaya Cha Namah Sahasrakshaya Cha Shatadhanvane Cha Namo Girishaya Cha Shipivishthaya Cha Namo Meedushtamaya Cha Shrumate Cha Namo Rasvaya Cha Vamanaya Cha Namo Brihate Cha Varshiyase Cha Namo Vriddhaya Cha Samridhvane Cha Namo Agriyaya Cha Prathamaya Cha Namo Aashave Cha Jiraya Cha Namo Shikriyaya Cha Shibhyaya Cha Namo Urmyaya Cha Vasvanyaya Cha Namo Srotasyaya Cha Dvipyaya Cha Namo Jeshthaya Cha Kanishthaya Cha Namo Purvajaya Cha Parajaya Cha Namo Madhyamaya Cha Pagalbhaya Cha Namo Jaganyaya Cha Budhniyaya Cha Namo Sobhyaya Cha Pratisaryaya Cha Namo Yamnyaya Cha Kshemnyaya Cha Namo Urvaryaya Cha Khalyaya Cha Namo Shlokyaya Cha Vasanyaya Cha Namo Vanyaya Cha Kakshaya Cha Namo Shravaya Cha Pratishravaya Cha Namo Ashushinaya Cha Shurathaya Cha Namo Shuraya Chavabhindate Chanamo Varmine Chavaruthine Chanamo Bilmine Chakavachine Chanama Shrutaya Chashrutasenaya Chanamo Dundubhyaya Chahananyaya Chanamo Drishnave Chapramrushaya Chanamo Dutaya Chapramrushaya Prahitaya Chanamo Nishangine Cheshudhimate Chanamas Tikshne Shavecha Yudhine Chanamas Swayudhaya Chasudhanvane Chanamas Shrutyaya Chapathyaya Chanamas Kaatyaya Chanipyaya Chanamas Sudhyaya Chasarasyaya Chanamo Nadhyaya Chavaishantaya Chanamas Kupyaya Cha Vatyaya Cha Namo Varshyaya Cha Varshyaya Cha Namo Meghyaya Cha Vidyutyaya Cha Namo Idhriyaya Cha Tapyaya Cha Namo Vatyaya Cha Reshmiyaya Cha Namo Vastupaya Cha Vastupaya Cha Om Hara 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 Om Namah Somaya Cha Rudraya Cha Namah Tamraya Cha Runaya Cha Namah Shangaya Cha Pashupataye Cha Namah Ugraya Cha Bhimaya Cha Namo Agre Vadhaya Cha Dure Vadhaya Cha Namo Antre Cha Haniyase Cha Namo Vrikshe Bhyo Harikeshe Bhyo Namastaraya Namah Shambhave Cha Mayobhave Cha Namah Shankaraya cha Mayaskaraya cha Namah Shivaya cha Shivataraya cha Namah Tirthaya cha Kulyaya cha Namah Paryaya cha Varyaya cha Namah Prataranaya Chottaranaya cha Namah Atharyaya cha Ladhyaya cha Namah Shashpyaya cha Phenyaya cha Namah Sikatyaya cha Pravahyaya cha Namah Irinyaya cha Prapathyaya cha Namah Kigum Shilaya cha Kshayanaya cha Namah Kapardine cha Pulastaye cha Namah Goshtyaya cha Grihyaya cha Namah Salpyaya cha Gehyaya cha Namah Kātyāya ca gavvareṣṭhāya ca namo Hṛdayāya ca niveshpyāya ca namah Pāgum savyāya ca rajasyāya ca namah Śuṣyāya ca harityāya ca namo Lopyāya ca lapyāya ca namah Urvyāya ca sūrmyāya ca namah Parnyaya cha Parnashadhyaya cha Namopa Guramanaya cha Bhignate cha Namah Akhidate cha Prakhidate cha Namova Kirikebhyo Devanagum Hridayebhyo Namo Vikshidhakebhyo Namo Vichinvatkebhyo Namah Anirhatebhyo Namah Amivatkebhyah Drape andhasaspate daridranilalohita Esham purushanam esham pashonam Mabhir maromo esham kinchanamamat Yate rudra shiva tano shiva vishvaha beshaje Shiva Rudrasya Bheshajitayano Mrida Jeevase Imagum Rudraya Tavaseka Pardine Kshayadviraya Prabharamahe Matim Yathanashyamasadvipade Chatushpade Vishvam Pushtangrame Asminnanaturam Mridano Rudrotano Mayaskridikshayadviraya Namasavidhemate Yaschanchayoscha Manuraya Jepita Tadashyamatavarudra Pranito Mano Mahanta Mutamano Arbhakam Mana Ukshanta Mutamana Ukshitam Mano vade pitaram mota mataram priyamanas tanuvo rudrarishaha Manas toketana ye mana ayushimano goshumano ashveshuririshaha Viran mano rudrabhamito vadir havishmanto namasavidhemate Ārārte gogna uta pūrushakne kshayadvīrāya sumnamasmete astu Rakshachano adhicha deva bruhyadhachana sharmayachadvibarha Stuhishrutam gartasadayuvanam mruganna bhimamupahatnumugram Mridāja ritre rudrastavāno anyante asmanniva pantusena Parino rudrasya hetar vrnaktu paritveshasya durmatirakhāyo Avasthira magavadhyastanushvamidhvastokāyatanayāya mridaya Midhushtamashivatamashivona sumanābhava Parame vriksha ayudhan nidhaya krittim vasana acharapinakam vibhradagahi Vikiridavilohita namaste astu bhagavaha Yaste sahasragum dhetayonyam asmannivapantuta Sahasrani sahasradabahuvostavahetayaha Tāsāmīśāno bhagavah parācīnā mukhākṛde sahasrani sahasrasho ye rudra adibhumyam teshagum sahasrayo jane vadhanvani tanmase asmin mahatyar nave antarikshe bhava adhi nilagreva shitikantha sharva adah kshamachara nilagreva shitikantha divagum rudra upashrita ye vrikshesu saspinjara nilagreva vilohita ye bhuta namadhipatayo vishikhasakta pardinaha ye anneshu vividhyanti patreshu pibato janana ye patham patirakshaya aila vridha yavyudaha ye tirthani pracharanti srikavanto nishanginaha ya etavantascha bhuyagum sascha disho rudravitasthire teshagum sahasrayo jane vadhanvani tanmase namo rudrebhyo ye prithivyam ye antarikshe ye diviye shamannam vato varshamishavastebhyo dasha prachirdasha dakshina dasha pratichirdasho dichirdashordvastebhyo namaste no mridayantu teyam dvishmo yascha no dveshtitam bhojam bhedadhami त्र्यंबकं यजामहे सुगंधिं पुष्टिवर्धनम् उर्वारुकमिव बंधनात् मृत्योर्मुक्षीयमामृतात् यो रुद्रो अग्नौ यो अप्सु य ओषधीषु यो रुद्रो विश्वा भुवना विवेश तस्मै रुद्राय नमो अस्तु एते सहस्रमयुतं पाशा मृत्यो मर्त्याय हन्तवे तान् यज्ञस्य मायया सर्वानवयजामहे मृत्यवे स्वाहा मृत्यवे स्वाहा प्राणानां ग्रन्थिरसि रुद्रो मा विशान्तकः तेनान्नेनाप्यायस्व नमो रुद्राय विष्णवे मृत्युर्मे पाहि तमुष्टुह्यस्विषुसुधन्वायो विश्वस्य क्षयति भेषजस्य यक्ष्वामहे सौ मनसाय रुद्रं नमो भिर्देवमसुरन्दुवस्य अयं मे हस्तो भगवान् अयं मे भगवत्तरः अयं मे विश्वभेषजो यगुं शिवाभिमर्षणः ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः स्वस्ति प्रजाभ्यः परिपालयन्ताम् न्यायेन मार्गेण महीमहिषाः ओ ब्राह्मणेभ्यः शुभमस्तु नित्यं समस्तलोकाः सुखिनो भवन्तु समस्तलोकाः सुखिनो भवन्तु समस्तलोकाः सुखिनो भवन्तु ओ शान्ति
Om Shri Sai Ram. Invoking Bhagwan's divine blessings, on the eve of Bhagwan's 92nd birthday, which we are all eagerly awaiting to celebrate tomorrow, our esteemed chief guest, Honorable Vice President of India, Shri M. Venkaiah Naidu Garu, has kindly consented to be with us today. He has kindly agreed to be in the abode of Bhagwan and has given us all great joy in just now, a few minutes ago, opening the Sri Sathya Sai Archives. Distinguished guests, respected elders, dear brothers and sisters, we will now have a small video presentation on the Sri Sathya Sai Archives. Jai Sai Ram.
Yada yada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata abhyuthanam dharmasya tadatmanam srujamyaham.
The Supreme Lord incarnates from age to age to fulfill a divine mission. Bhagwan Sri Sathya Sai Baba incarnated to guide humankind back to goodness. This he continues to do in accordance to a master plan, a unique aspect of which is the enormous legacy he has left behind. This master plan unfolds in stages. In the early hours of the morning, in a small village in South India, in the humble home of a pious family, the Lord chose to take birth in a human form. In the initial years, Satyam, exceptional in every way, gave hints but also waited for the right time to announce his true identity. When the right moment had arrived, seated on a small rock, the 14-year-old Satyam sang.
Manas bhajare guru charanam, kustara bhama sagara charanam.
He was no more just Satyam, he was verily the Guru, Sri Sathya Sai Baba, Swami for his devotees. Several years later, seated in a small tin shed, a few devotees put up for him, Swami wrote a letter to his brother Seshamaraju. This historic letter contains a divine proclamation of the priorities of this avatar, his mission statement. At the age of 25, Swami inaugurated his mission headquarters, Prashanti Nilayam, or the Abode of Peace. On the occasion of Shivaratri, a few years later, Swami launched the Sanatana Sarathi, a monthly journal still in existence in several languages. The journal published the transcripts of Swami's discourses and also articles by devotees. But the most anticipated segment of the journal was a new article written by Swami for every issue. No one knew at that time that Swami would personally write one article every month, non-stop, for over 26 years. Those articles have since been compiled into the Vahini book series. Like all earlier avatars, Swami also incarnated to revive adherence to Dharma and to eliminate the wicked. But his approach was very unique. In one of his discourses, Swami declared, "This avatar has not come to cut down the termite-infected tree, but to save it." He thus chose the path of divine love or prema to transform hearts. Darshans, bhajans, interviews, discourses, festivals, travels, serves. In every conceivable way, Swami only radiated this prema. Unfolding another stage of his master plan, Swami, the world teacher, in answer to a sincere request, agreed to have his voice transmitted via a satellite radio channel. Sai Global Harmony, popularly known as Radio Sai, was thus born. Radio Sai was also to be a part of a bigger mission, to work under the umbrella of the Sri Sathya Sai Central Trust, which Swami founded to carry out his incomparable projects of selfless service. Radio Sai's role was selfless service in the digital dimension. Right from the 1940s, Swami allowed photographs to be taken with the understanding that they would not be used for any commercial purpose. Slowly, as technology changed, people began taking audio and video recordings of Swami. Professionals, enthusiasts, and devotees from all over the world recorded events and preserved them as cherished memories. Radio Sai very soon became the central repository of these media assets. Later on, a prayer was made to Swami to bless the preservation of these originals as per international archival standards. Swami blessed the project and also indicated where the archive building should come up. The Lord's timing is always perfect, and a magnificent building has sprung up on top of the hill like a shining temple. The sanctum sanctorum of this temple is in the form of 6 ultra-modern vaults meant for the preservation of the media assets. Utmost care has been taken to maintain the prescribed humidity and temperature levels in each vault specific for each media type. Since the entire working area has been designated as a clean area, great care has to be taken to ensure that all the specified clean room practices are meticulously adhered to. In his infinite compassion, Swami also blessed the archive with thousands of pages of handwritten content, which he so lovingly left behind. These invaluable manuscripts will be preserved in special cubicles filled with a calibrated proportion of inert gases. This controlled environment, which will be made possible by an indigenously designed gas filling system, will arrest any further degradation of the original paper. This entire system sets a very high standard for paper preservation, comparable only to the technology used for the preservation of the American Constitution. Thus, the archive building will focus mainly on the preservation and extension of the life of the original media recordings, which have already been digitized. Several processes like metadata tagging and classification of the digital assets are also being carried out at present. As these many and diverse activities were going on, Swami thrilled everyone's heart with a unique benediction. Out of the blue, a senior devotee came to Radio Sai in 2016 and offered one of the most precious original manuscripts. No one could believe their eyes when they saw it. So many decades later, fresh and pristine. Yes, it was the original letter which Swami wrote to his brother in the year 1947. Here it is, the mission statement of the Sri Sathya Sai avatar. A physical copy of his master plan. In the letter, Swami writes,
అఖిల మానవులకు ఆనందమునగూర్చి అఖిల మానవులకు ఆనందమునగూర్చి రక్షించుచుండుటే దీక్షనా I
My life is my message, Swami declared. He also said, make your lives my message. Swami will continue inspiring humankind to make everyone's life reflect his message through this divine legacy, preserved in the Sri Sathya Sai archives.
Om Shri Sai Ram. Today at 3:45 p.m., with the divine blessings of Bhagwan Shri Sathya Sai Baba, the magnificent looking Shri Sathya Sai archives was inaugurated. We now present to all the devotees a glimpse of the inaugural ceremony. The Honorable Vice President of India, Shri Venkaiah Naidu Garu, was welcomed by Veda chanting and Purna Kumbham by the students of the Shri Sathya Sai Higher Secondary School. The chief guest then formally inaugurated the state-of-the-art Sri Sathya Sai archives by cutting the ribbon and lighting a lamp at the altar. He, the trustees of the Sri Sathya Sai Central Trust, and the other dignitaries were present at the foyer where the chief guest unveiled two plaques. Padma Shri Professor G. Venkatraman, former director of Radio Sai Global Harmony, and the visionary behind the Sri Sathya Sai Archives project, explained the technical aspects of the archive to the honorable chief guest. The chief guest was then led to the vault area by Professor Sudhir Bhaskar, the director of Radio Sai Division, where the guests were given an overview of the 6 atmosphere-controlled, fireproof and waterproof vaults built with clean room technology of the class 1000 category. The valuable physical media related to Bhagwan will be preserved in this dust-free enclosure. One of the vaults contained the most precious document, the epochal letter written by Bhagwan on the 25th of May 1947 to his elder brother Sheshamaraju Garu, outlining the avataric mission. This letter written by Swami at the young age of 21 can be considered the vision and mission statement of the Sri Sathya Sai avatar. Shri R.J. Ratnakar, trustee of the Sri Sathya Sai Central Trust, explained the monumental importance of this document to the guest. In fact, it is worth constructing an entire archive to preserve just this one document. The chief guest was then given an overview of the building management system room, the fire suppression system, the technical management system room. The whole archive will be centrally monitored and controlled. We are eternally grateful to our dearest Swami for being the only avatar to will the preservation and propagation of his legacy via these documents, audios, photos, and videos. Jai Sai Ram.
On behalf of all the devotees who are present in Prashanti Nilayam and the hundreds and thousands of people who are watching this program live being webcast, it is my pleasure to invite the Honorable Vice President, Sri Venkaiah Naidu Garu, to kindly address the gathering and seek Swami's blessings. Jai Sai.
Honorable trustees, Sri Chakravarti Garu, Sri Prasad Rao Garu, Sri Ratnakar Garu, Honorable People's Representatives, Sri Krishnappa, Sri Srinivasulu, and Sri Raghunath Reddy, and galaxy of distinguished sons of this great land who are all devotees of Sri Sathya Sai Babaji, and thousands of disciples who have come from different parts of the globe and different parts of India, and my young children, my dear sisters and brothers, all devotees of Sri Sathya Sai Ji, namaste to all of you. I am extremely fortunate to be with all of you on the eve of the 92nd birth anniversary of Sri Sathya Sai Babaji and the launch of the Archieves today. People who have seen Baba in their lifetime, they can cherish their memories. But the life is long. It flows on. It goes on. To make others also who are not fortunate to have his personal darshan, these archives which are created here with the blessings of Swamiji, they'll be really very useful for hundreds and thousands of years to come for the devotees, for the people across the globe to have reminiscence of the Sri Sathya Sai Baba. That's why I feel it's a pious responsibility taken up by the trust and ably guided by Professor Venkatramanji and Sudhir Bhaskarji and other technicians who have volunteered with their wisdom, with their knowledge to come and take up this project. Because history is written, undoubtedly. But Sathya Sai Ji has created history. And that has to be written by somebody. And history is written. But this information, in this modern age, where we are all moving with the IT, which has become the new beauty, and has become the part of our duty, can make this country and the mankind mighty also, if it is used properly. And by these archives today is information with confirmation. Because I always believe information with confirmation is more than an ammunition. It's an ammunition. To give jnana, remove ajnana, pass on the information for generations to come. It's really a great initiative with the blessings of Sri Sathya Sai Ji, taken up by the trustees. So I would like to really compliment the scientists, the technicians, and the trustees for getting this noble work done, and that too in a beautiful It was beautiful, but the work also was beautiful. And then I am filled with joy when I came here and went to that amidst chanting of Veda, and also to be amidst you, all the devotees who have come from different parts of the globe. I had the fortune of meeting some of them, getting introduced to some of them also. There are people from various parts of the globe who are all devotees of Sri Sathya Sai Ji. And also, the lot of intelligentsia from our country, including Justice Venkatachalaya, all these great people have made it to this occasion. Tomorrow is Sri Sathya Sai Ji's birthday celebration. But tomorrow I am deprived of this because I have already committed myself to a convocation at some other place. And I move on. So when they told me, when Ratnakarji informed me, I felt really sorry that I am deprived of an opportunity of being present on the historic occasion. But later I myself informed them, if they can accommodate me, I'll come one day before and be present here. Function or no function is no problem. Having the glimpse of devotees is having the darshan of Sathya Sai. True to my nature, I am always on the move. And I always have some ideas, sometimes I'm filled with emotion. I recollect the first time when I came here, along with Lal Krishna Advaniji, and then met Swamiji, first time in my life. Swamiji was moving around, he came to Advaniji, Advaniji introduced me also to Swamiji. He said, no, I know Venkaiah Naidu. Then he asked me, how is your health? I was really surprised because I had some health problems, but how Swamiji came. Then he said, do not have tensions. Move on. Things will be easy. God bless you. This is the advice he has given. Because I always have that emotional feeling to any cause which is dearer to my heart, which I believe. I always used to move on. Of course, now I'm in a different responsibility. Some of my friends are very happy that I become vice president. I asked them why. They said, at least now you will take some rest. And they said, your health will be taken care. I said, I have given GPA of my health to the Lord. So whatever he decides, will go accordingly. Because I have the habit of meeting the people, greeting the people, talking with the people, walking with the people, working with the people. That gives me immense pleasure because our Puranas, our Itihasas, our Gurus always say, Manava Seva is Madhava Seva. The essence of Sathya Saiji's preachings, teachings is simple, love, affection. You meet him, half of your problems are solved without hearing anything from him. Hear him, then the other problems also are solved. So the love and affection he has given to the society. And the message he has given is that we are all one and we must involve ourselves to the service of the mankind. So love, affection, service, and for that peace. Peacefully living together, that is the life and message of Sri Sathya Sai Ji, and we are really blessed to have it. Sri Sathya Sai Baba is a loving God to his devotees, a universal teacher and humanitarian to others, inspired millions of people across the globe to actively participate in service of humanity. We don't have any such example in the recent past in the history of a person influencing this many number of people in this many countries. And even now, when Swamiji has reached the world, still the teachings and preachings are practiced in 135 countries, and people are indulging in service, and even today, the service goes on with the blessings of Swamiji. The inspiration. Why we celebrate all this? This is to give inspiration to others, to give others, to motivate them also. And then he was a great transformational leader, transforming the lives of the people, transforming the minds of the people. That's the need of the hour, particularly in the present situation in the world. Transformation of the people to the original values, to the great traditions. Friends, I always feel proud that I am born in this great country, a country which has got thousands of years of civilization. Adi kalam nunchi, Veda kalam nunchi, Punya kalam nunchi, Purana kalam nunchi, mana purvikulu anubhavinchi, rangarinchi, melavinchi, manaku andichinatu yokka jeevana satyam edaithe undo, aa varasatvam manandariki kuda javasatvanni istundi, dani spurtiga theesukoni మనందరికి కూడా టేకింగ్ ఇన్స్పిరేషన్ ఫ్రమ్ అవర్ ఫోర్ ఫాదర్స్ ఫ్రమ్ అవర్ కల్చర్ వీ మస్ట్ మూవ్ ఆన్. వీ హవ్ సీన్ ద హిస్టరీ, వీ రెడ్ ద హిస్టరీ, మెనీ ఆఫ్ ద కంట్రీస్ కేమ్ అండ్ ఆక్యుపైడ్ ఆల్ అదర్ కంట్రీస్ ఇంక్లూడింగ్ అవర్ కంట్రీ. దే లూటెడ్ అస్ సమ్ టైమ్స్, దే చీటెడ్ అస్ ఆల్సో, దే హవ్ టేకెన్ అవర్ వెల్త్ ఆల్సో. బిఫోర్ ది బ్రిటిషర్స్ కేమ్ టు ఇండియా, ద ఇండియాస్ జీడిపి వాజ్ 27% ఆఫ్ ద వరల్డ్ ఇండియాస్ జీడిపి ఎట్ దట్ టైమ్. నౌ వీఆర్ స్ట్రగ్లింగ్ హార్డ్ టు రీచ్ 7%, 8% అండ్ ఆల్. బట్ ది ఇన్స్పిరేషన్ దట్ ఇండియా గివ్స్ టు ద పీపుల్ ఈజ్ స్పిరిచువలిజం. అక్రాస్ ద గ్లోబ్ పీపుల్ ఫీల్ ఇండియా యాజ్ ద స్పిరిచువల్ హెడ్ క్వార్టర్స్ అండ్ హీర్ ఈజ్ అ స్పిరిచువల్ లీడర్ హూ హ్యాస్ గివెన్ అస్ దట్ స్పిరిట్. ఈ నాట్ ఓన్లీ ట్రాన్స్ఫార్మ్డ్ ద ఫిజికల్ ల్యాండ్స్కేప్ హియర్ ఇన్ పుట్టపర్తి, వి సా హౌ పుట్టపర్తి వాజ్ అర్లియర్, హౌ నౌ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ బికమ్ ఎ ప్లేస్ ఇన్ ద వరల్డ్ మ్యాప్. పుట్టపర్తి హెస్ ఆక్యుపైడ్ ఆక్యుపైస్ అన్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ప్లేస్ టుడే థ్యాంక్స్ టు బాబాస్ బ్లెస్సింగ్స్. సో ఈ ట్రాన్స్ఫార్మ్డ్ ద ఫిజికల్ ల్యాండ్స్కేప్ హియర్ ఎట్ పుట్టపర్తి, ఎ స్మాల్ విలేజ్ హెస్ బికమ్ ఎ వైబ్రంట్ గ్లోబల్ స్పిరిచువల్ రిట్రీట్. It has become a global spiritual retreat. I have no hesitation in saying it. He transformed the villagers' lives through the provision of drinking water. He transformed and demonstrated how values can be inculcated through education and how health care can be delivered to the poor. Health care, education, water. These are the basic requirements for any civilization to flourish. And Swamiji, with his foresight, with his vision, has focused on this and motivated people across the country and across the globe to serve the people. And then he has done such a commendable job, which the governments also could not do during their lifetime. I am particularly impressed by the service given to the poor. I am told more than 25 lakh operations were conducted with the blessings of Baba, heart operations. And secondly, the drinking water is a major source. Sometimes people say that you can have a life without wife, but you cannot have a life without water. I am not suggesting that you should not have wife. Wife is very comfortable, very, really, my wife, I feel very comfortable. She is responsible for my, this journey also, at not giving me any trouble and always supporting me in my endeavors. That's the saying, of course. And then more than anything else, I am particularly, because I can tell you frankly, before coming to Puttaparthi earlier, I was not a devotee. I used to just read. After coming here and seeing particularly the education transformation he has given, the discipline, the hard work, the motivation of the children and the Bharatiya parampara and traditions he has inculcated in thousands and lakhs of students, that is really a very great service that Baba has done to the cause of the education. His teachings emphasize truth, love, peace, right conduct, and non-violence. What is required? That is the message of his life. Love, truth, peace. Because there cannot be progress without peace. If there is tension, there can be no attention. Individually, as a country also. So he has emphasized on the truth, love, peace, right conduct and non-violence. The service activities of Sathya Sai Baba's organizations that have worked in the national spirit are truly commendable. It is heartening to note that the clarion call of Sri Sathya Sai Babaji motivated devotees across the world to form service organizations in about 125 to 130 countries to serve the underprivileged and needy. Our Shastras, our Puranas always tell us, we all feel proud of our culture and heritage. I can tell you the Hindu culture, the heritage, is so great among all the cultures we have seen. That's why this civilization is able to survive. You have heard about Babylonian, heard about Greece, Athens, you have heard about Egypt, you have heard about Romans. But what happened to those civilizations? Why is an Indian civilization, the Bharatiya Nagarikata, why it's able to survive? Because it believes in universal brotherhood. This country has no history of attacking any country. We believe in Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu. We believe in Sarva Dharma Samabhavana, not for political sake. The so-called secularism which we politicians, we means till yesterday, I'm not a politician now. I'm retired from politics, but not tired from public life. We talk about secularism, this and all, that's political, this thing. The constitution also did not have secularism initially. But the secularism is strong in India because of it is in the DNA of all Indians, irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion, and region. Yehi Bharatiyata ka mahatva hai. Yehi Hindutva jisko kahte hai. Hindu ek jivan paddhati hai. Hindu mazhab nahi hai. Mazhab hai ek puja paddhati. It's a way of prayer. But culture is way of living. We feel proud of our culture, our heritage. This is the central essence point of Sri Sathya Sai Baba's teachings and his life. So friends, the super specialty hospitals, the general hospitals, mobile hospitals, the four campus deemed universities described by the National Assessment and Accreditation Council, NAAC, as a crest jewel of the Indian university education system. That's the word they have used. Two residential schools and class 1 to class 11. The Sathya Sai Central Trust is a public charitable trust, not a religious trust. Underline, because when we use the word Hindu or Bharatiya or India, it's not a religious connotation, it's a cultural identity of this nation. That's why we feel proud, and we should not hesitate to use the word. Politicians may hesitate sometimes for political reasons and all, and that too out of not having proper understanding. Friends, today the trust under the divine guidance of Sai Babaji has provided clean drinking water to a million of people in 700 villages of Anantapur. And many of the projects were sanctioned not only here in Medak, in Mahunaga, districts of Telangana. A project to modernize Kanderu Reservoir nearby native place in Nellur, Andhra Pradesh. And a canal from Kanderu to Pundi Reservoir in Tamil Nadu. The Telugu Ganga drinking water supply to city of Chennai. These are all some of the small examples. There are many more. The service activities in the field of education, healthcare, providing safe drinking water, and all other free services taken up by the Sathya Sai Central Trust under the guidance of Sathya Sai Baba have been having a great impact in the society in India and humanity worldwide. Sri Sathya Sai Central Trust has been carrying on the service activities which were started by Sathya Sai Baba in the same spirit which they are initiated. What is the respect we can show to Baba? Praying here, coming and offering garlands, or erecting a statue, or having the photo in our house. The real tribute to Sai Babaji is follow his teachings and preachings. Serve the people. That is the greatest salutation. That's the greatest salutation to Sri Sai Babaji's memory. Carrying forward the service to the people. I'm happy that the trust and trustees, they're all wedded to that cause and doing it in a very simple and also in an exemplary manner with the same spirit which he has given to all of them. He is the embodiment of selfless love, and his life is a saga of selfless love for the humanity. Sri Baba served all humanity irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion, and region. He practiced the unity of all faiths, symbolized by his statement, "There is only one religion, the religion of love." I quote him. "There is only one language, the language of heart. There is only one caste, the caste of humanity. There is only one law, the law of duty. There is only one God, is omnipresent everywhere." everywhere. This is what he has said. So Baba always exhorted people to do selfless service. He says, hands that help are holier than the lips that pray. See, a powerful, powerful, meaningful, thoughtful statement. Hands that help are holier than the lips that pray. Our people also casually say, no, don't pay lip service, service by hand. See, such a powerful message in his teachings. In fact, this is a grand Indian tradition of serving every human being as a divine, and therefore serving human beings has taken service to God. When I was talking about service, this culture, one of the boys got up and asked me, sir, what is culture? I told him, simple way of living, jivana paddhati. He said, sir, I'm not able to understand. Can you explain it is better, how it's Indian culture is great and compared with others and all? I said, by the Indian way of living, respecting elders, respecting teachers, respecting pasu pakshadalu, chimaku chakkare betti, pavuku palu posi, chettuku bottu betti, pasuku dannam betti, adaka pavitravaina jati manadi bharatiya. Avanni cheppadu sir, adu kaadu sir, kodiga sulabanga ardhamaye bhashalo cheppandi sir annadu. Nenu appudu cheppanu adaniki, endaya ante nee daggara unna rottenu nuvvu tinte అది ప్రకృతి. నీ రొట్టెను నువ్వు పక్కన వాడి దగ్గర ఉన్న రొట్టెను పీక్కొని తింటే అది వికృతి. నీ రొట్టెను ఆకలిగా ఉన్న వాడికి పంచి పెడితే అది సంస్కృతి, అదే భారతీయ సంస్కృతి అని చెప్పారు. ఇఫ్ యు ఈట్ యువర్ రోటీ బ్రెడ్, ఇట్ ఇస్ న్యాచురల్, ప్రకృతి. ఇఫ్ యు స్నాచ్ అవే ద బ్రెడ్ ఆఫ్ అదర్ ఫెలో అండ్ ఈట్ ఇట్, దట్స్ వికృతి. అండ్ ఇఫ్ యు give some of your bread to the helpless people, that is called as samskruti, that is Bharatiya samskruti. Friends, I need not explain and elaborate further. I am delighted that the trust has completed the project to supply drinking water to another 118 villages in Anantapur district, also constructing houses and also getting involved in disaster relief operations in the Hudhud cyclone in Visakhapatnam, and also the floods in Chennai. About 100 Sathya Sai schools in the country set up by the devotees are being provided with financial assistance. The divine inspiration provided by Sri Sathya Sai Baba continues to drive the trust new initiatives. So I would like to call upon all the devotees, take the message of Baba forward and then take advantage of these teachings and preachings and pass it on to others. I feel extremely happy to inaugurate the Archieves today. As I told you, information with confirmation is more than a nomination. In his lifetime, Sathya Sai Babaji had written several books, addressed devotees thousands of times, thousands of forums across the globe, written letters personally, and messages to people of all walks of life. Many of these teachings and messages are available in different formats, both audio and visual. Sathya Sai General Central Trust has collected this and has preserved them for posterity so that they would be available for the seekers of knowledge in the years to come. There is a veritable treasure house of 7,000 manuscripts, 9,000 audio spools, 5,50,000 feet of films, 5,000 CD and DVDs, 10,000 video tapes, about 1,800 hours, and 1,50,000 photos. Amazing that all these were collected with the blessings of Baba. This can be used by researchers and those who was to study the message of this great sage. A state-of-the-art archive center has been established as per international standards in the Prashanti Nilayam for this purpose, and this archive center, with one of its kind in the country, is built on multiple levels with custom-designed special walls. The building has inner and outer shells. You have just now had a glimpse of it. Sterile corridors, illumination at 300 lux, and also high level of dust control and robust security systems. I am told that system can ensure preservation of the archived material for hundreds of years. When I saw this, I was inquiring from Professor Venkatraman, what about the Indian original constitution? How long it can be preserved, whether he can give a helping hand to preserve the original Indian constitution in its original form. Because the constitution is like Veda to all of us, to Indians. These items have been here digitized and kept in archive buildings. This would facilitate content across the electronic form and help disseminate the message of Sathya Sai Baba. Sri Sathya Sai Baba was a great spiritual leader who distilled the essence of Indian philosophical heritage. He is the messenger. He is the spiritual leader who distilled the essence of Indian philosophical heritage and conveyed it in a very simple but effective way to the masses. As the great sage Narada describes a divine person, Satarthi Lokan Satarthi, he is not only navigates the ocean of life, but also helps all others to cross the ocean. That's the life. He used to address his devotees as Paramatma Swarupulara. The very word Paramatma Swarupulara, it fills you with the joy that you are also an incarnation of the God, Swarupulara. And then he used to very affectionately call and write letters, Nayana, Nayana. That's the culture, our culture. The embodiments of divinity. With his perspective, he said, if you lift the hand to serve, to help, to console, to encourage another man, you are lifting it for God, because in every man is God there. He also has said, service is worship. Each act of service is a flower placed at the feet of God. That's the message given by Babaji. For him, selfless service to humanity was the essence of devotion. This echoes the conception of devotion that Narada gave us in his Bhakti Sutras. Sa Parama Prema Rupa. This unconditional, sublime love can transform human beings into devoted souls serving God through service to humanity. This is the grand ideal set by Sri Sathya Sai Babaji before us and demonstrated throughout his speech and actions and life, and that he proved it is possible. It is the same spirit and eternal flame he has kindled that is making our lives more meaningful. I invoke Baba's gracious blessings on the trust and all of us around the world so that we can lead fulfilled lives. May we follow the path of Satya, Dharma, Prema, Shanti that he has shown us. May we commit ourselves to work as Sathya Sai guided us for the progress of humanity with love, compassion, right conduct, and trustworthiness. Namaskar, Jai Hind.
His Excellency, the Vice President of India, Sri Venkaiah Naidu Garu, has thrilled us with his address, which he has just now concluded. I've been asked to propose a vote of thanks, but I cannot resist the temptation of mentioning a small secret about him, which I came to know. Exactly a month ago, Sri Venkaiah Naidu Garu was invited to attend a very big function in Bangalore. He had given his commitment to attend, but due to a small setback in his health, he could not make it for that function. And when we tried to put some pressure on him, he lifted his hand and said, I am under the control of the Home Ministry, and till my wife permits me to travel, I am not in a position to attend your function in Bangalore. The only reason he gave was that I have been so much in public life that I cannot say no to anybody who invites me for a good cause. And one more aspect which he highlighted then was, he said, while I believe in God and I'm a spiritual person, but I do not consider myself to be a deeply religious person in the sense of ritualistic worship. But the address which we heard today makes it abundantly clear that Sri Venkaiah Naidu Garu has actually gone way above the religious way in which we live and has reached the level of spirituality. Bhagwan Baba always taught us that to do good to others is most important, and as the old Subhashita says, paropakararta duhanti gavaha, paropakararta vahanti nadyaha, paropakararta midam shariram. Just like how the cows are giving you milk with the sense of helping others, Just like how the rivers are flowing beautiful clean water for everybody to take and enjoy from it with the idea of helping others, human life will get fulfilled only by making ourselves available for service to humanity. And I think Sri Venkaiah Naidu Garu has actually led that kind of life in his political life and his public life. And we are very happy that he has come to us today. He has participated in this event. He has opened the Sathya Sai archives, which, as he has rightly pointed out, is a very important step in the preservation of Swami's message for posterity. It is a collection of a large number of things that we need to preserve. Only when you realize the amount of work which Swami put in personally, you will be able to understand. You know, there are notebooks in which Swami has written from the top left-hand 1 millimeter column to the last 1 millimeter column in his own handwriting. He was writing the entire Sanatana Sarathi for so many years. All of that, by Swami's grace, is available with us. And that is what is going to be preserved for posterity. And it's indeed our good fortune that Sri Venkaiah Naidu Garu, the Honorable Vice President, has come all the way from Delhi for this. We are aware that he has a very important arrangement, program that he has to attend shortly after he leaving Puttaparthi, and therefore he is taking leave from us now. We thank you very much, sir, and we hope to see you more often in a more relaxed frame of mind, spending a few days amidst all the devotees. As you have yourself said, seeing devotees is like seeing Baba. Therefore, we invite you to come more and more often, sir. Thank you very much. Sai Ram.
Gajanana गजानना हे गणपति देवा गजानना हे गणपति देवा जय 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 गणपति देवा करुणा सागर प्रेम
Bhola Bhandari Baba, Shiva 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 Sai Baba. Bhola Bhandari Baba, Shiva 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 Sai Baba. Rakshak Deen Dayala Parit Pavan Sai Baba Anath Rakshak Deen Dayala Parit Pavan Sai Baba Shiva Sai Baba Yogeshwar Sai Murari Yogeshwar He Tripurari Yogeshwar Sai Murari Yogeshwar He Tripurari Shiva Shiva Sai Baba Anath Rakshak Deen Dayala Patit Pavan Sai Baba Bola Bhandari Baba Shiva 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 Sai Baba Yogeshwar Sai Murari, Yogeshwar He Tripurari. Nityananda Brahmananda Premananda Sai Baba. Nityananda Brahmananda Premananda Sai Baba. Shiva Shiva Sai Baba
On the occasion of the 36th convocation of the Sri Sathya Sai Institute of Higher Learning, the students of the university offer at the lotus feet of their most beloved founder chancellor, Bhagwan Sri Sathya Sai Baba, a drama titled Sankirtana Saram, The Soul of Singing. Thank you.
Shankara Sada Shiva.
Your grace has safeguarded this kingdom from all perils that jettison its welfare. Today, my son, the crown prince of this land, who was on the brink of life and death, the light of this lineage is about to be extinguished. Spare this innocent one in the bounty of your benediction. Bless him, O Lord. Bless us.
Do not worry, Maharaj. All will be well. The Lord shall erase all our worries. He is the Apad Bandhava, the Anatha Rakshaka. All we have to do is to surrender to His will and pray wholeheartedly.
Long live the King!
What news do you bring, O Mahamantri?
I bear joyous tidings, my Lord. The Almighty has showered His blessings on the Prince. He has regained consciousness, and the Rajavaidya has said that he will recover very soon.
Do I hear right, Mahamantri? Oh Lord, you have showered your grace on this family once again. Mere words cannot express the joy in my heart. At this twilight hour, you have carried to my door the very rays of dawn. Your words have renewed my hope. Thank you, Mahamantri. Take this reward for bringing me this wonderful news.
Your Majesty, but I have not done anything. It is indeed the mellifluous prayers of this troop that has moved the Lord, returning your son from the verge of death itself.
You have rightly opened my eyes, Mahamantri. Dearest members of the Bhajana Sankirtana Samiti, I am once again eternally indebted to all of you.
It is the ever-merciful Lord, O Maharaj. He is the ocean of compassion who never forsakes his children. He takes care of us no matter what. He always listens to our prayers. It is He alone who deserves all our gratitude.
Rightly observed, O Venerable One, but it is only because of your Sankirtan, offered with utmost devotion, that the Lord has answered our prayers. Please accept this as a token of infinite debt from a father and the protector of the realm.
Pardon us, Maharaj, but we cannot accept this offering.
Has there been a lapse on my part? Foolish me. I put the price of my son's life on a mere bag of coins. Tell me, how much can I offer, O sires? My heart at this moment fathoms no value.
Pardon us, O Emperor, but we mean to cause no discomfort in this cheerful hour. We accept no reward, for our sampradayam forbids us from doing so. The divine grace is our only source, driving force, and reward.
We have set out as His instruments on this selfless mission of uplifting humanity, and He alone is the master of our fates. We surrender entirely to His will
and live as per His divine plan.
Besides, the royal treasury already allots a sufficient sum for our sustenance. Our bare necessities are all taken care of. Luxury and identity are but extra baggages hampering our hands that pine to hold on to our Lord's palm. Forgive us, O gracious King, but we seek nothing more. The Lord's bountiful miracle to our earnest prayer is all the reward we merit for this lifetime.
This is true devotion indeed. Your purity in thought, word, and deed fills our hearts with more love for the Lord, showing us the way to Him.
Now that the Crown Prince is recovering, we kindly implore Thee to grant us leave. Radhe Krishna.
Pranams. May the all-merciful Lord shower His blessings on all of you. Radhe Krishna.
Makes you laugh on this divine occasion?
I'm surprised how some people effusively praise devotion.
But isn't it worthy of all the praise?
Can I ask you something? How does such a transient spirit deserve such a pedestal?
Because devotion alone is the path to immortality.
I think art is the simpler means. Enough talent, and you can redefine time itself.
Rightly observed. But what is talent without devotion?
And what is devotion without talent?
Devotion makes talent art.
You hang on to devotion like it's the timeless absolute.
Devotion isn't devotion if it's not timeless, my friend.
Well then. Let's look at the state of affairs of our Bhajana Sankirtana Samiti, let's say 100 years from now.
Indeed. Let us see. I am certain, where the foundations are rooted in divine, fate itself surrenders.
Padamavagamavagarizadani sarigamavadarizada अच्युतं केशवं रामनारायणं कृष्णदामोदरं वासुदेवं हरिं वासुदेवं हरिं
Chakrapani, you appear upset, brooding over something. Is there anything bothering you?
Today was Chakrapani's divine magic.
Sharma Garu, you were no less.
Aha, what energy, what vibrations.
Shiva Shiva.
Oh, stop this childishness, Raghupati. Enough of your energy and vibrations. Do you not see that our songs and kirtans fall on no ears, let alone deaf ears? There was literally no one save God out here to hear us singing away to glory.
But isn't that our aim? To please God and God alone?
You do not get his point, Raghupati. What purpose are we serving when there is nobody to listen to us and connect to God?
Chakrapani, since when has singing for an audience become our goal? Our motto was always to reach out to God by offering whatever little talents we have. For us, it is music, so be it. Despite the talent, the aim is an offering to God.
Then why do we sing at the temple, Raghupati? Why can't we just sing at home and stay content? Indeed. After all, it takes tremendous time and effort to arrange for every program. Precisely my point, Raghupati. Instead of singing to these silent pillars, why not walk past open windows and fill all homes with joy? If we can lend joy as the stars, why be mere lamps at this temple door? Let us travel and perform, spreading happiness. We must venture into all genres, explore our talents and grow. Wouldn't it be injustice to all those we can serve with our potential if we stayed this way?
But this is not our parampara, Chakrapani. We should not sway away from our tradition. It is this parampara that has kept us close to God.
Definitely. In this milling crowd, there is so much rush to see God up close.
Enough of your retorts. Our tradition has been everything for us. We are defined by it. But for our tradition, who would be...
Traditions can be changed, Raghupati. Our tradition is what we make of it. I believe it is opportune time to explore new horizons and not be so stagnant in this cocoon.
But have you forgotten the day you enrolled in the system? Eager to fill your late father's gigantic shoes. You were the only one eligible.
I stepped in basking in his aura, assuming I could recreate his legacy. But today, look at our adamant stage so obscure, forgotten to legend. Indeed, singing here would only be a selfish habit if we did not include the masses who need the real upliftment.
Shiva Shiva.
If none of you agree, I accept it. I shall forge my own destiny. I had hoped my concern would be understood. But it appears my anguish is personal.
Chakrapani, are you...
Yes, Raghupati. It's time that I took wings to find my identity as his messenger in the world. I have decided to leave and will be gone at the first light of dawn.
But the world out there, it's not so easy, Chakrapani. I speak from the experience of silenced memories.
It is this experience that I seek. Let me fall, endure, and scale this ladder of success.
If this is the Lord's divine will, so be it. Do not stop him, Sharmagaru.
Chakrapani, you have our sincerest wishes and prayers for whatever you strive for.
But how will the group run with only one singer?
Worry not. For we are but the mere forerunners of a tradition that dates back 300 years. It has survived before us and will survive long after. For it is a shelter and not a shade. This home shall always leave its doors open for anyone who has even an iota of Shraddha unto its tradition. We are only a part of it today, for we chose to surrender to its light. And that shall always live on. And so long as we are a part of it, it is our duty to safeguard its pristine vision.
Life always seems to oscillate between change and choice. Perhaps there is a lesson waiting to be learned. Oh, it's already closing in on Sandhya. About time we returned home.
Nilalona meenu nigidi duramu paru baita muredaina baraledu sthana balimigani tana balimigadaya vishwadabhirama vinuravema.
So, as Shastri euphemized, do you now accept? Given the importance of place to an artist, sooner or later,
its greatest fall. For where does a lamb survive? In shelter or in the street?
Isn't that the selfishness of a lamb to brighten only its home?
Not if the home is an altar where God resides.
But look at this group now, thrown into darkness. Their brightest flame having left.
And whose loss is it? Talent pays heed to circumstance. Devotion knows only surrender.
But who's going to emancipate such a group that has nothing to offer?
Not all talent seeks reward, my friend.
I'm curious when you'll resign to fate and accept talent is the only practical reality.
My time to laugh now. Where talent treads bounds, devotion finds its limitlessness. See how fate transpires.
Aha! I shouldn't say this myself, but the paisam has come out very well today. It will surely brighten your mood. Come, partake a sweet morsel and cheer up.
Oh goodness, Gopanna, your cooking is the last thing to cheer us up.
Perhaps you should let our Ramana fast. It is anyway the auspicious day of Ekadashi. We could have his share too.
Shiva Shiva. I fail to see what troubles you all so much that you have forgotten to savor the simpler joys.
It's not your fault, Gopanna. It's our accursed fate. When the mind wanders, alas, even the Sadruchilu are unwelcome guests.
Why do all of you lose heart? Have you already forgotten about our performance next week at the Komanapalli village? We can use whatever we get to fix our instruments' attire and failings.
And also, Gopanna's dishes to add little weight to our Sharmagaru.
Neelu bosi kadigi nityammu sodhinchi koodu betti meeda koka gatti enni paatlu paduduru ee dehamunakai vishwadabhirama vinuravema.
You're also irate over improving your own personal issues. What of our Lord's divine abode? The very soul of our existence. Look at the dilapidated condition of our Lord's dwelling that we have all forgotten.
You have rightly reminded us of our true purpose, Shastri Garu. Let us intensify our prayers with this purport, and surely brighter days will be here. As if on point, Murthy Garu is also here. Gopanna, get a royal portion of your paisam for Murthy Garu.
Right away.
Murthy Garu has always been our harbinger of good news. Surely he must bear some cheerful tidings.
Shiva Shiva, Shiva Shiva.
Your silence spells grave, Murthy Garu.
I'm extremely sorry to inform you that your next performance at the Devi temple in the nearby Kommanapalli village has been cancelled.
Shiva Shiva!
I know this is not the appropriate time to bear such news, but I had to convey it at the earliest. I tried my best, even speaking to the sarpanch of the village, but to no avail.
Is there no other alternative possible? Can it not be postponed?
I already looked for all possibilities, but was adamantly refused. I'm afraid there is little I can do.
Murthy Garu, please do not be sorry. You tried all you could. If not this, we shall perform at another time. One single cancellation is not an issue to be deliberated upon. After all, what can go wrong when the Lord is with us?
What can go wrong? It's not one cancellation, but the cancellation of our one and only chance. We have but one singer and no foreseeable future. What can go wrong?
Shiva Shiva.
Ramana, the loss of one, though painful, is not the end. No matter who leaves, the tradition shall survive. Does the sky have a dearth of clouds to sing its song? Is our faith and surrender to the Supreme Lord so brittle?
Shiva Shiva.
So shall we sit here mourning our fates with our arms crossed and not even try looking for replacements?
Murthy Garu, please try looking for a singer. Someone who understands our ideals and supports our cause.
Hope at least the one who comes has the hunger to finish my forgotten feasts here.
It is our duty to search for a replacement, and we will. But of this I am certain in my heart. He who belongs here has already begun his journey. Babu, whom do you want to meet?
I heard that you were auditioning for new members. Can I try too?
So, we have our first candidate. What is your name?
Madhav.
So, what can you do?
I would like to sing.
Go ahead. Sing. We shall all listen to you.
Darshan do Ganesham नाथ मोरी अखिया प्यासी रे दर्शन दो गणेशम नाथ मोरी अखिया प्यासी रे
ट्रूथ बी टोल्ड
बट आई सो बैडली वांट टू बी पार्ट ऑफ दिस ग्रुप कैन यू प्लीज टेक मी
My dear child, I see myself knocking on these very doors once upon a time. I would be ungrateful to deny such an innocent heart a selfless shelter. I will not restrict you from helping around. Stay on and cater to all the mundane requirements of the group. Music isn't your calling, but service is everyone's.
Yes, yes. I will do anything in whatever little capacity I can.
Okay, come. Let me show you around.
Excuse me, sir. Is this where the Bhajan Sankirtan Samiti stays?
Yes, sir. You are at the right place. How may we help you?
Radhe Krishna. I am Damodar from Gopalpuram. The news has spread across the land that this group is taking new members. I am desirous of being a part. Do you think I'm eligible?
It is true that one of our singers has left. But our doors are always open to like-minded individuals joining us. As far as your eligibility goes, let us evaluate your caliber. So, what is it that you wish to sing today?
Oh, I am not a singer. I play the flute.
But at this point, we need a singer, not a flautist. We may not be able to help you much.
I heard a lot about this group. The reputation of open arms that precedes its devotion itself. If I'm not welcome here...
We are so sorry. We were carried away by our shortcomings. Do make yourself comfortable. So, what have you heard of our tradition?
A 300-year-old tradition to raise the collective consciousness of humanity lost in the abyss of vices. A lighthouse of pristine devotion that guides the restless mind stranded in the Bhavasagra. Performing at the temples, you redirect the straying souls back to his lotus feet. What can be a nobler, selfless service?
Pardon us for judging you at the first instant. You have indeed come when we felt our foundation stir. I believe your ideals shall pillar the edifice of our renaissance. You truly belong here.
Is that all you want to hear?
We got lost in your profound discernment of our virtues. We almost forgot to ask you about the music. Please, play something for us.
The winds of change, whom do they spare? In fact, today they have made the flickering flame of our lamp steady again.
Welcome to the group, Damodar.
Everything has a destiny, everyone a destination. Shastri Garu, surely you must have a padyam on the inevitable course of destiny.
Chepabadda swati chinuku mutyamaye. Neeta badda chinuku neeta galise Praapti kalgu chota phalamela tappura Vishwadabhirama vinuravema.
So the kid who knows nothing and a flautist, they are the respite to all their travails.
where you see the varied instruments, broken and perfect. I see the director preparing his masterpiece.
Your optimism is the very poison that has plagued the heart for centuries.
But what's to lose hope and mourn barrenness when you have the very ocean in your heart?
You seem too arrogant of their surrender. Wait till the first occasion that puts them in chaos.
I'm sure there is nothing that can affect an anchored boat. No matter the storm, nothing sways the bamboo.
You've forgotten the alluring power of instant reward to opportunity.
I don't see why this group would wilt to such a silly game.
Chakrapani left alone, but not before sowing a thought. Let the first nourishments arrive and watch their disintegration blossom.
Lead me there. Let me show you how devotion always prevails, given its inspiring idols.
Damodar Annaya, can I ask you something?
Yes.
Will you teach me how to play the flute?
Oh yes, why not? But I thought you wanted to be a singer.
That was my dream. But I clearly cannot sing.
And what makes you think that?
I was such a disaster. You should have heard my audition. They said I croak like a frog and that I cannot sing. That's when I realized I'm only fit for serving the masters of the house.
No, no, no. You have misunderstood the very essence of this art. You have given up on your aspirations based on the world's opinion. Let the ambition in your heart and love for God drive your dedication, and His grace shall transform you into His very flute.
But how will any amount of practice turn a crow's vocal into a cuckoo's?
Oh Madhava, do you truly believe that God cannot perform miracles with a single gaze? The Lord seeks only our yearning, Madhava, not our talents. When I was a child, I was taunted that I was unfit even for washing the clothes. So I took up that very challenge as my offering to God. I made this washing stone my drum, and the husus, my song to Mother Godavari. Today, every citizen knocks on my door for that simple joy of sparkling clothes. This very act of cleansing became my symphony, Madhava.
Anaga anaga ragamati sayillu chunundu tinaga tinaga vemu tiyanundu sadhanamuna panulu samakuru dharalona Vishwadabhirama Vinuravema.
You're right, Shastri Garu. All one needs to do is practice sincerely. Do it as an offering of love and longing, and every work becomes a worship.
Your words inspire me. I shall abide by your suggestion and put my heart and soul into it.
Madhava, call the others. Damodar, Ganapati, we have received an invitation from the Maharaj of Mysore to perform as a part of this year's Dasara celebrations.
Well, isn't that amazing? Look, Ramana, I told you, the Lord will take care of all our needs. This invitation is definitely His blessing sent our way.
Raghupati, but you don't seem as excited about it.
He has his reasons, Murti Garu. We have been invited by the king to perform on the eve of Dashami. But isn't that the very evening we have always kept aside to perform at our village temple?
Well, does it really matter where we perform? It's the occasion of Dashara after all.
But our tradition calls for us to perform at our own temple.
Yes, I too agree with Raghupati. Our group has abided by this tradition since the time of its inception. It will be wrong if we act on our impulses and break this heritage.
We can always keep our temple performance for another date. I don't really see much of a busy schedule on the other days.
Your idea seems to be quite logical to me. Or maybe we could request the astrologers to reschedule Dashera.
Shiva Shiva!
I see no reason why we should reject the king's invitation. Moreover, would not a better exposure bring in brighter opportunities? More concerts will bail us from this penury.
Damodar, you haven't spoken a word since. What are your thoughts on this?
Well, I think we should decline the offer.
But do you not see it, Damodara? This invitation is our sincere prayer answered. It is sent to us when we are in dire need of some money and support. Leave aside our personal issues. Every now and then, Ganapati Shastri reminds us of the condition that the temple is in. What have we been able to answer to him? Why not accept this as a God-sent blessing? You all plan to spurn this offer? Be practical.
Our music has always been a worship. And after all this, if money is still our motive, then we have lost. You fail to see the irony. We seek to sing soulful wisdom, forgetting what we sing. What did Tyagaraja embody?
Yagabrahmam, we have visitors.
We come from the court of Maharaj Saraboji. We seek an audience with Kakarla Tyagabrahmam.
Yes, I am the one you seek. Such nobility at my doorstep? This tiny hut bears no generous hospitality.
It is not the material luxury we seek, Tyagabrahmam, but your divine voice that has brought us to your doorstep.
News of your impeccable music has reached the ears of Maharaj Saraboji. It is no secret that even the great Sunti Venkatramanaya Garu has offered his own seat to you.
These somber walls do not befit your brilliance, Tyagabrahmam. Maharaj Saraboji has invited you to perform at his court.
And he has promised a generous reward as well.
No. I cannot. I am sorry, but I cannot come with you to the court.
What are you saying? Hear them out, Tyagabrahmam. The king has promised 10 velis of land and a bullion of gold. All that in return for just a song in his praise.
On the contrary, brother, I shall be foolish to accept the king's coffers.
Look at our sorry state of poverty. And your daughter has come of age to be married. Seek refuge in the shade of the mighty emperor. His one glance will solve all our troubles.
They offer me luxuries beyond my imagination. But I cannot barter my heart for wealth.
You make no sense, Tyagabrahmam. Of what use is this talent if it cannot aid your living?
You tire yourself swimming in these shallow waters. But I pine for the boatman who will take me across the ocean of life. The living that you seek, of what use is it? The joy it gives is ephemeral at best and temporal in the least. My heart is attached to the very source of permanent bliss.
Mamata bandhana yuta narastuti sukhama sumati tyagarajanutuni kirtana sukhama.
If your decision is final, we shall convey the same to the Maharaj.
But be assured of one thing, Tyaga Brahmam. This reply of yours shall offend the mighty emperor.
Which emperor do you speak of? I seek refuge in the supreme monarch of this entire creation. Tell the emperor that he cannot buy my songs. My songs shall forever be in praise of my lord. Tell him that I shall sing of none but my Ramachandra.
Nidhi chala sukhama ramuni san.
Therefore, we who serve the Lord through Bhakti Marga must not be swayed by these tangible gains. Tyagaraja showed us the timeless path that we must all traverse.
Yes, well said, Damodar. We must surrender our actions as a love for the art in itself and not for the material reward that follows. One such folly and greed shall distract our peace. The Lord shall take care of all our needs as He always has.
Our Dashara performance is a promise that we fulfill every year to our beloved Lord. Accepting the King's invitation may fuel our glory, but we would have failed to take one more step towards our Lord's embrace. I say, we apologize to the King and humbly reject that offer.
Rani di kori naradadi రానున్నది కోరకున్న రానే వచ్చున్ తానెంత చింత చేసినా కానున్నది కాకపోదు కదరా వేమా.
వెల్, దట్ సెటిల్స్ ఇట్ దెన్. వాట్ హ్యాస్ టు హ్యాపన్ షెల్ హ్యాపన్. ఐ బిలీవ్ వీ ఆల్ నో వాట్ టు డూ విత్ దిస్ ఇన్విటేషన్. సో వాట్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ ఆర్ వీ వెయిటింగ్ ఫార్? Now that you have observed this unwavering anchor of devotion, what of your talent?
You pride on the tautness of this devotion, but you do not comment on its lofty price.
Therein lies your greatest disillusion, for you always put a tag on everything.
When talent belongs to society, it automatically becomes qualified to be evaluated.
And that's the greatest difference, for devotion isn't a trade between the two, but a union into one.
I fail to understand. Isn't even devotion an offering that involves a giver and a taker?
That is the fundamental virtue of devotion. It is a journey to conquer one's pride.
Conquer one's pride? Isn't the celebration of one's potential and hard work legitimate?
Talent
is an inherent seed in every heart. But only pride assumes it's the achiever, forever giving momentary shade, but no fruit.
And what does devotion do? Satisfy everyone's hunger?
It loses all sense of identity. Merging in the Lord, in the first note, it determines the thirst of our love for God. Look at our very Chakrapani that you love to gloat. See the story of love, the triumph of hope over experience.
Amba Mohini Devata Tribhuvani Ananda Sandhaini Vani Pallava Pani Venu Murali Gana Priya Lolini Kalyani Vuduraja Bimbavadana Dhumraksha Samharini Chidrupi Paradevata Bhagavati Shri Raja Rajeshwari Raja Rajeshwari Shri Raja Rajeshwari.
Chakrapani, let me introduce our special guest. Meet Narayan Rao, the richest man on these shores. As far as the secret goes, his coffers rival the royalty. A busy man, he was to leave this morning. Yet when we told him that we were coming to your home, he instantly joined along.
Wah, Chakrapani, wah. Trust me when I tell you this. Every praise that you've ever received has been an understatement. Your unparalleled voice must surely move the heavens.
Did I not tell you, sir? Chakrapani is a master of his art, a paragon in his own right.
I remember your name as one of the highlights of the Krishna Gana Sabha last week. I couldn't resist my curiosity from listening to your genius. Fate has indeed been kind this evening.
Well, the artist has little to do when the art itself is so immense in its merit. It is my pleasure that you have come to meet me, sir. Please make yourself comfortable. I was just wrapping up my practice.
Adente, sing us one more song. I came all the way to indulge in your genius. Padama, pad.
I am afraid I must apologize, sir. But it's past my Sandhya hour of worship and I've just completed my final prayer to the Mother.
What is music if you can't give it to those who come asking?
Chakrapani,
you must not be so naive.
You crave for a career, but do not know the face of an opportunity.
Make him happy, and no luxury will ever remain a dream.
Why are you so hesitant? What is it you seek? You need not do anything for charity. Don't insult my wealth. Take all these coins. If it is less, I shall write you an estate. But sink to our restless senses now.
Have all of you lost your mind? Music isn't some pleasure to entertain one and all. Kindly do not desecrate my values, at least in my own home. This is the sacred altar for me, where I worship the divine with my garlands of swaras. I don't intend to make it a graveyard for elongated eulogies.
Oh ho. No wonder you are a pale shadow despite all your light. Look at Vetori Timmaya and Venkata Subbanagaru, stalwarts of the trade, decked with finest palatial richness this splurge. You will remain a mere footnote in history with this arrogant modesty.
With due respect, sir, you have the wrong impression of my approach to this equation. Jealousy and professional rivalry can never encroach into my worship of this art. I pursue it as a prayer.
not performance, for all who come seeking whenever they want.
Stop it! You are the only devotee and we are all beggars seeking alms. Give that money to remind yourself whose hand is above. This is the last paycheck for your insolence. And you both, next time when you call me somewhere, let me know in advance if people know how to value others' time and respect their identity.
So what are your grand plans hereafter? Angering the one man who shares supper with the elite in the kingdom. Kacheris at home to the swaying garlands on the silent walls?
You left your group on the conflict of their ideals, calling on their monotonous spirit. Perhaps you deserve this destiny of solitude.
How far do you expect to go with such irreverence to the society that gives you respect? Look at your sorry state of affairs. If you are so keen on insulting everyone who comes to your home, at least intimate us in advance, so that we shall keep away and save at least our self-respect.
Now sweep these rugs and collect these scattered notes and gold. It is the last of your earnings in the city. And the next time you sit down to sing, look at that wealth and remember, no more.
Is this all that my music is worth? A noisy bag of polished metal? What have I done? What have I done, Lord? Have I turned away from prayer to pedestal, auctioning my ideals for luxury? I only strove at every turn to spread your light. I even left home to make your entire world my altar. And yet, today all I am in this world is a label of pleasure. Where have I faltered? What is my shortcoming? I need your soothing hand to arrest my trembling heart and show me the way. Today I understand all those words. One day, you might have nothing despite all the talents you have. But never forget that God resides in your heart and He is the only wealth you'll need. In trying to use my talent to make the world connect to God, I'd forgotten to connect myself. Oh Krishna, rushing to your lotus feet to embrace your divine form and glory, I'm coming home.
दशरथात्मजमप्रमेयम् सीतापतिम् रघुकुलान्वय रत्नदीपम् आजानुबाहुम् अरविन्द तला रामं निशाचर विनाशकरं नमामि नमामि नमामि
stupendous, Madhav. Your alap, it was soulful.
Didn't I say it then itself? That he does have it in him to make it as our future lead.
Shiva Shiva.
I knew it all along. After all, when fed with the food I cook, isn't it only natural that wonders blossom?
Don't pat your own back, Gopu. Poor boy. He's just started. Let him wait another year and he will forget all his ragas on your ragi.
No. You're right, Gopanna. Your nourishment is actually the secret to all our sparkling auras. Shiva Shiva, Shiva Shiva.
Don't joke, Damodara. Our Gopu will take it all too seriously and mix all the jaggery in tonight's dessert in such happiness.
Damodar never lies. Barely been here for 6 months. He alone has found the taste buds for my efforts.
Indeed, Gopanna. Few realize that if we happily sit at the Lord's feet, it is because our stomachs are full with your compassion.
But what have I done? I wield but these wooden spoons and blunt knives.
And that is your perfect instrument. For where the Lord holds the flute, you have a ladle. Yours is an art that is an instant solace for every mood. Every dish you make with such dedication that it becomes our prasad. After all, it isn't about what we do, but why we do it.
Damodar, today it feels like I have partaken the nevedya of my own offering. You have truly reminded me, our duty is our greatest offering.
A messenger has come with a royal decree. My heart feels a trepidation of what awaits us.
Pray, open it, sir.
The Mysore Mahasamasthanam, under the benign sovereign monarchy, extends his infinite gratitude to the Bhajana Sankirtana Samiti for painstakingly making the great sacrifice of your annual performance at the village temple to perform at his villas during the Dasera Mahotsavam this year. Although he was extremely delighted to host your kacheri, he is filled with remorse for this erring. He now understands your refusal to accept any reward. It is the Maharaja's sincere prayer that he be allowed to restore the Venugopala Swami Devalayam to its past grandeur. Through this small act, the Maharaja hopes that he is able to convey his gratitude and admiration to this exalted group.
The Maharaja wants to renovate our temple because we sang at his palace? But we never...
Surely the Maharaja is mistaken. How is this even possible?
Where you see a mistake, I see a magic touch of our mysterious Lord. This is his miracle. He alone knows the sorrow in this heart that broods over the meager tulasi garlands that adorn him instead of the finest ornaments. He has heard our prayers and answered.
God himself never asks for anything. He knows only giving and forgiving for his verily love. And he resonates in every heart as that love. And so, knows what was our most heartfelt wish.
I too cherish that desire. Ever since we lost Chakrapani's father, the temple too has lost its past glory and ethereal aura. Perhaps it is his divine will to restore the lost grandeur.
Shiva Shiva.
Looks like Damodara's remarks have brought about a new beat on this old drum.
No, Keshava. It is time I noticed the obvious in my blind pursuit for material wealth. I have long been mistaken, turning away from his magnanimity. I now see his divine hand in this unforgettable experience.
Shiva Shiva.
With such happy tidings, let us all visit the temple and meet Murti Garu right away for the renovation plans.
But on one condition, we should perform on the inauguration day after renovation. What?
tell Acharya Garu, the maniharam will be collected from the jeweler this evening. This evening, and will be handed over to him tonight. Ranganayakulu, just 2 days left for the program. Inquire about the installment to be paid.
Raghupati, I have only been a custodian of our temple. But it has always been all of you who poured the very soul into its existence. I am so happy that this work is happening in your deserving hands.
No need for such big words, Ganapati Garu. You yourself have said that we are his instruments. Wherever we may be, we remain his. And his work is our only worship.
God bless you.
Raghupati, Ramana, look who has come.
Chakrapani? Raghupati, after all this while, I am standing here as a stranger in my own home. I pined to fall in the tender lap of my beloved Krishna again and came rushing. Even if for a single moment, just a gaze of his solacing look on this weary soul. Today I realize what this group has always offered to those who stood on their shores.
You have not come to find the Lord, Chakrapani.
The Lord has called you back.
Look at you, lean beyond recognition. Hasn't the world that stole all your music nourished you enough in gratitude? Don't they know the value of this priceless treasure?
I've experienced it all, Sharmagaru, as you had warned. The fickle ways of the world that has found its own anchor of wealth in the sea of samsara. But that has only strengthened my yearning for the Lord as I stand here today, closer to His feet, devoid of my identity.
Indeed, Chakrapani, life may take us through many tribulations, but in the end, there is always a home to return for the child, His divine lotus feet.
Chakrapani, you may have left us physically, but you are always here. We hadn't stopped keeping your plate or your sitting mat. Today, your presence here is the proof that family is the greatest fortune and that the Lord lives in our smiles.
I never meant to desert this family. I left this altar thinking I could take God to the homes. But I almost lost my most precious possession, the inseparable bond with my Lord. Today, I've come here to experience the love for God once again, which alone fills all our hearts to the brim with bliss.
Nadaka nerchu papanalu gadugulesi tirigi talli vadini cherunatlu cherenidigo tirigi hari charana sannidhiki jagamu vidi vadiga chakrapani.
Rightly said, Shastri Garu, the mother's lap alone is our destination. And in this lap of the divine parent, aren't we all the same, no matter what our shortcomings?
Chakrapani, meet our new flautist, Damodara.
He joined us a few months back, and you will be mesmerized by his rendition. Damodar, he is our lead singer, Chakrapani.
No, Raghupati. I cannot claim what once belonged to me. I can't even accompany you. A place in this home is itself like a life's reward.
Dearest brother, as you know, we have a program in the evening after the temple reopening. We are to conclude the evening's festivities with a kacheri. You should lead. The Lord has always opened His door the moment your soulful prayer knocks. Come, let us go and practice.
But I should not be leading.
All right. Both of you sing together.
So after that line, I should begin the konakol, right? Tata tirigida, tata tirigida, tata tirigida.
Yes, that is the way to end. Three avartanams.
What is the matter, Raghupati? You look worried.
Damodar is becoming well known for his last minute entries. I wonder what work has caught up with him at this 11th hour.
Huh. I last saw him in the courtyard when we were all about to leave. He assured me that he would lock the house and join us here. I have sent Madhav to look for him. Ah, see, here he comes. Madhav?
Annaya is nowhere to be seen. I even checked with the neighbors. They said that he left for the temple. Hasn't he reached?
What do we do now? We are just minutes away from our performance.
And that too, his piece is very crucial in the entire concert. Raghupati, shall we wait or...
Raghupati? Raghupati, say something. It's time.
We had announced that the kachiri will start at 7 o'clock.
But what about Damodara? I mean the flute piece.
The Lord cannot be kept waiting.
Premaswarupulara, this is the consummation.
of every journey, from you to me, where I've sown a seed of myself in each of your hearts. Nourish it with utmost faith and make it your prayerful offering. And in that journey of devotion, filling the spirit of all talent, we will merge. Every heart shall become my very altar, where I imprison myself with joy. I shall forever be with you, above you, beside you, and inside you. Take that one step of love towards me, and I shall rush taking 100 steps towards you.
స్వరూపులారా, ఈ విద్యార్థులను చూస్తే నాకు ఎంతో ఆనందం వేస్తుంది. ఇలాంటి విద్యార్థులు నాకు చిక్కారు కదా, ఇంతమంది ప్రేమకు నేను నోచుకున్నాను కదా అని నాకెంతో ఆనందం. కనుక మీ యొక్క ప్రేమనే నా యొక్క విలువ. నాకు ఈ ఖర్చులు కానీ డబ్బులు కానీ ఏమాత్రం నాకు విలువ లేదు. ఈ ప్రేమను తరిగిపోకుండా పెరిగేటట్టుగా ఇంకా చూసుకోండి.
ప్రేమ పంచగా ప్రేమను పెంచగా ప్రేమ తత్వమును ప్రబోధించగా మాధవుడే మానవుడై వచ్చి మాను ఒకరిగని
మీరు ఎక్కడుండినా కూడా నేను వెంట జంట ఇంటా ఉంటాను.
ఇంటా వెంట జంటని ఉండి ఎల్లవేళలా తోడుగ నిలిచే అడుగులలో మాగమ్యము కనుగొన్నాము. అడుగులలో మాగమ్యము కనుగొన్నాము. మా హృదయవాసి
जिसे दिल ने चाह है.
तुम ही हो साई माँ जिसे दिल से चाह है.
तुम ही हो साई माँ जिसे दिल ने चाह है. तुम ही हो वो जिसे दिल ने दिल से चाह है.
Sai Ram. Gopal, 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 Gopal. Krishna. Govinda, Govinda, Gopal, Sai Krishna. Govinda, Govinda, Gopal, Sai Krishna. Govinda, Govinda, Gopal. Sai Govinda, Govinda, Gopal. Gopal, Radhe Krishna, Govinda, Govinda, Gopal. Gopal, Gopal, Gopal. Govinda, Govinda, Gopal, Radhe Krishna. Sai Govinda, Govinda, Gopal. Gopal, Radhe Krishna, Govinda, Govinda, Gopal. Sarva Dharma Priya Deva.
Shivaya namah Shiva, 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 Shivaya nam
Shivaya Namah Shiva Shivaya Namah Om Namah Shivaya.
हरे सर्व धर्म प्रिय साई हरे
राम हरे साई कृष्ण हरे सर्व धर्म प्रिय साई हरे
Om Garu Rupa Jaya Sai Ram. Invoking Bhagwan's divine blessings, 23rd of November marks the advent of the Yugavatar, our most beloved Bhagwan Sri Sathya Sai Baba. This year, we are celebrating the 92nd birthday of our most beloved Bhagwan. Tomorrow, during the early morning prayer session of Omkaram and Suprabhatam in Sai Kulwant Hall, from 5:10 to 5:40 a.m., Bhagwan's Sannidhi curtains will be kept open. All devotees can receive Bhagwan's darshan from where they are seated. The morning session in Sai Kulwant Hall will commence at 8 o'clock with Veda chanting. At 8:20, the students from Bhagwan's educational institutions will be offering a cultural program comprising devotional songs and instrumental pieces by the Panchavadyam, Nadaswaram and band groups. After the music program, the annual report of the Sri Sathya Sai Central Trust will be offered at Bhagwan's Divine Lotus Feet. Sri S.S. Naganand, Trust Member, Sri Sathya Sai Central Trust, will present the highlights of the annual report, which will be followed by a book release ceremony written by Dr. V. Mohan, Trust Member, Sri Sathya Sai Central Trust. We then have two ardent devotees of Bhagwan addressing all of us. Mr. Leonardo Guter from Sathya Sai International Organizations and Professor Kamaraju Anil Kumar, translator of Bhagwan's Divine Discourses. After the two talks, we will be blessed with Bhagwan's Divine Discourse. The morning session in Sai Kulwant Hall will conclude with Bhajans and Mangal Aarti, followed by Bhagwan's Divya Darshan. Tomorrow's evening session in Sai Kulwant Hall will commence at 5 o'clock with Vedam chanting, which will mark the commencement of the Swarna Rathotsavam procession of the magnificent golden chariot of Bhagwan from Mandir Ganesha around Yajur Mandiram and back to Sai Kulwant Hall. At 5:30, we will be blessed to witness and participate in the grand Jhula Mahotsavam. During the Jhula Mahotsavam, a devotional music program will be offered at Bhagwan's Divine Lotus Feet by an internationally reputed Carnatic singer, Sri Abhishek Raghuram, and his team of musicians from Chennai, Tamil Nadu. Tomorrow's evening session in Sai Kulwant Hall will conclude with Bhajans and Mangal Aarti, followed by Bhagwan's Divya Darshan. Jai Sai Ram.
ఓం శ్రీ సాయిరామ్. స్వామివారి దివ్యానుగ్రహ ఆశీస్సులతో రేపటి రోజు నవంబర్ 23వ తేదీ శ్రీ సత్యసాయి భగవానుని దివ్య అవతరణ జరిగిన మహత్తర పర్వదినాన సాయి కులవంత్ సభా మండపంలో ఉదయం ఓంకారము మరియు సుప్రభాతం జరుగు సమయాన, అనగా 5:10 నుండి 5:40 వరకు భక్తులు ఆసీనులై ఉన్న చోట నుండియే స్వామివారి సన్నిధానమును దర్శించుకోవచ్చు. సాయి కులవంత్ సభా మండపంలో రేపటి ఉదయ కార్యక్రమం 8:00 వేద పఠనంతో ప్రారంభమవుతుంది. 8:20 స్వామివారి విద్యాసంస్థలకు చెందిన విద్యార్థులు భక్తి గీతాలు, పంచవాద్యము, నాదస్వరము మరియు బ్రాస్ బ్యాండ్ వాద్యములతో కూడిన ఒక సాంస్కృతిక కార్యక్రమాన్ని సమర్పిస్తారు. తదుపరి శ్రీ సత్యసాయి సెంట్రల్ ట్రస్ట్ యొక్క వార్షిక నివేదికను శ్రీ సత్యసాయి సెంట్రల్ ట్రస్ట్ సభ్యులు శ్రీ ఎస్ఎస్ నాగానంద్ గారు సమర్పిస్తారు. వీరి ప్రసంగానంతరం శ్రీ సత్యసాయి సెంట్రల్ ట్రస్ట్ సభ్యులు డాక్టర్ వి మోహన్ గారు రచించిన ఒక పుస్తకం ఆవిష్కరించబడుతుంది. ఈ కార్యక్రమానంతరం సత్యసాయి అంతర్జాతీయ సంస్థకు చెందిన శ్రీ లియనార్డో గూటర్ గారు ప్రసంగిస్తారు. తదుపరి స్వామివారి దివ్యోపన్యాసాల ఆంగ్ల అనువాదకులు ప్రొఫెసర్ కామరాజు అనిల్ కుమార్ గారు ప్రసంగిస్తారు. తదుపరి స్వామివారి దివ్య సందేశం సాయి కులవంత్ సభామండపంలో రేపటి ఉదయ కార్యక్రమం భజనతో కొనసాగి మంగళహారతితో ముగియను. అనంతరం స్వామివారి దివ్య దర్శనం. సాయి కులవంత్ సభామండపంలో రేపటి సాయంకాల కార్యక్రమం 5 గంటలకు వేద పఠనంతో ప్రారంభమవుతుంది. అదే సమయాన అనగా 5 గంటలకు బంగారు రథంపై స్వామివారి స్వర్ణ రథోత్సవం వినాయకుని గుడి దగ్గర నుండి ప్రారంభమై యజూరు మందిరం పక్క మార్గం నుండి సాయి కులవంత్ సభామండపంలోనికి ప్రవేశించును. 5:30 స్వామివారి ఉయ్యాలోత్సవం కనులకింపుగా భక్తులు తిలకించగలరు. ఈ కార్యక్రమం జరుగుతున్న సమయాన చెన్నై వాస్తవ్యులు మరియు అంతర్జాతీయ ప్రఖ్యాతిగాంచిన శ్రీ అభిషేక్ రఘురాం మరియు బృందం ఒక సంగీత కార్యక్రమాన్ని సమర్పిస్తారు. సాయి కులవంత్ సభామండపంలో రేపటి సాయంకాల కార్యక్రమం భజనతో కొనసాగి మంగళహారతితో ముగియను. అనంతరం స్వామివారి దివ్య దర్శనం. జై సాయిరాం.